Good morning. Today I'm going to speak about reading comprehension passage. Some tips how to improve reading. I searched some online materials and found some of the points, and I'm using it as pointers, and I will explain. So you can also search and find such tips, because reading comprehension is very important. It is now used to check whether these candidate can read and understand and present matters. So this is very important, and you will find such questions appearing in all exams. So don't just study for the university exam, but prepare for competitive exams. So you have to understand how to read and write answers. So don't expect to find the correct answer in the passage itself, because they'll be asking about the tone, making maybe asking something else. So like that, it can be different. So it is always good to practice how to overcome difficulties in reading comprehension. And here I found some very interesting points which I have taken it down. And these are all from various websites. So you can also refer and get more information, more techniques. But I'll use this as only as a pointer, and I'll try to explain my points, because something has to be there on the screen for you to, for the smooth functioning of this lecture. So here the person has given the first point as eliminating the words or phrases. So he says that students are unable to understand the given reading comprehension. That is a difficulty. That is something very crucial, because some students are not able to understand the meaning or what is actually highlighted or presented by the person. So to overcome this, you have to do a kind of vocabulary exercises. You have to read more passages. You have to read newspapers. You have to read editorials. Then you will get information. So some technical words are likely to appear, because most of the passages are from scientific essays from related to environment, related to informatics, related to other things, even from automobile industry, some essays can appear. So you have to have a vast knowledge. So in order to develop this, you have to read. You have to read magazines, you have to read India Today, you have to read Frontline, read Reader's Digest. All these will help you to improve your language. So remember, you are not preparing to write the university exam alone. You are preparing to face a very tough competitive exam. So you have to start practicing, because I have found that more than 10 passages sometimes asked. So you have to develop your speed, you have to develop your vocabulary, you have to develop your reading skills to understand a passage. That's why we have included 10 passages in this as model. But these passages are simple passages, and it is your duty and also my duty to make sure that we read more passages. So after these 10 units are covered, I'll be adding more passages, links to you, so that you can read it online and come up with answers. So your part is very important here. I can just be a guide, and you have to really take it seriously. Don't think that this is not very important, because reading comprehension, you can usually, the passage will be before you, and you've got the question, so you can answer easily. Okay, this for the university exam, it is true, but what about the competitive exams? See, if a serious student prepares seriously and pay attention to what I am saying, or what is written here, or what others, experts have already commented and posted in various YouTube videos and on websites, you will get a good idea about how to prepare for reading comprehension, which is really important. Don't think that you will be able to find answers easy. Because when I was writing exams, UPSC exams, I found this section very difficult, in spite of the fact that I studied English. In fact, of the fact that I had the habit of reading plenty of books, still found some passages very difficult. The questions will not be that easy. So always remember this. When you are going for the competitive examination, you have to be perfect. And there is no second chance. So this is very important part. Reading comprehension part is very important. And you have to really, really work hard to get marks in this paper. So remember that always. So here we find that some people don't understand and every word, but you get a kind of a gist of it. Now, the point that this particular writer is pointing out, and which I think is true to a good extent, is that you have to eliminate some parts that are not useful for, or that something that is not needed to focus on the keywords, and you have to focus only on the keywords. See, for example, if it is an essay about flood, you have to focus on flood and not on something else, or maybe the description of the flood, poetic description is given. Don't focus on that, but focus on the facts. So that is what the person is saying. So to achieve that, you have to have real practice. Then you have to find your strength first. There are two methods. One is to read the passage and the other is to read the questions first, so that you will get the keywords from the questions and look for that in the passage. So time management is very important in competitive exams. So you have to either select the usual method of reading the passage and then going after the answers, or reading the questions and then reading the passage. So this both are very effective. So you have to, as students, you have to find out which is your strength. So if you ask me personally, if it is a competitive exam, I will ask you to read the questions first and see the keywords. But if it is a university exam, I will ask you to read the passage and then go to the questions. In both ways, it is good. One is a very practical approach. The other is the usual conventional mode, and that is the right mode also. But in competitions, it's always good to be smart. So when you are approaching it in a smart way, you find that reading the questions is more effective first. So you read the question, try to understand what the passage is about. All these things, you have to do it very quickly. And one problem with reading the questions first is that you will not be able to read the passage with full attention, because the questions will be there in the background and you'll be searching for the keywords. This can be overcome only through practice. So without practice, if you are a person without practice, the best option is to read the passage first and then go to the questions. But if you are a person who has practiced this method and you are capable of storing the questions in your brain while reading the passage and identifying the keywords, then it is fine. Otherwise, don't attempt this, because you'll be bothered about the questions, you'll be bothered about the keywords, and you will not be able to concentrate and read the passage. So it's always good for people to first read the passage and then go into the questions. But I suggest you read the questions first and then go to the passage. If you are an expert, if you have had enough training, then go for this method. Otherwise, read the first passage and then read passage first and then go to the course. It depends. Okay, I hope you understood what I, it may appear contrary because I am saying that both are good. Yes, actually both are good. Depends on the person. Okay, so for example, you are eating lunch, you eat the curry first and then go and attack the rice, which is good. So you will say that mixing up is good. Okay, that's a third method. You read one question, then try to find the answer by searching for the keyword that is there in the question. That is also good. And so now you have three methods. One, reading the passage in the beginning, then reading the questions in the beginning. Then the third one, mixing. So this is for you to find out which is good for you. So find your strengths and identify your weaknesses. So when you have achieved that, it will help you get more good marks in this paper. So now the writer here, he has asked you to improve, or suggested to methods to improve vocabulary, and this is good. Vocabulary, improving vocabulary is good, but that doesn't mean that you have to read each and every passage and go after the meaning. No, that is not, that is a very bad habit, because that will hinder the reading process. So in order to get used to all these vocabulary and other things, or to learn how to improve your vocabulary, you have to go on reading. So here he has suggested something like reading newspaper stories, comics. That's quite common thing. And you come across a very good word, so you note it down in a small book. Then if you want, you can go and search the dictionary afterwards. Maybe after, in the evening, you read it in the morning, then you go to the search the dictionary when you are free in the evening, and you note down all these good words and how they are used. It's very easy to say, but difficult to follow. But this is good. If you are very determined, you will be able to improve your language a lot. But I always suggest to skip the dictionary look habit and go on reading, so that you will find how a word is used in different contexts. You will not be able to get the meaning immediately, but you will get the meaning after you have read for maybe 10, 20 days. You will start recognizing this word. This word will establish, or you will get familiar to this word, and you understand the different contexts this word can be used. So what is the difference between understanding the meaning of a word from a context and understanding the meaning of a word from dictionary is that when you look at the dictionary, it is a kind of a technical knowledge. You know the meaning, you know, you understand all those things, but you will not know, be able to understand how to place this word in a sentence. So, whereas if you understand this the meaning, or you go on reading and get knowledge, information from the text or from the words used, the good thing is that you will know how to use the word. So two methods are there to understand or learn or develop vocabulary. One is to go on reading and referring dictionary only when required. The other is noting down all the important words and learning from the dictionary. The first method, you will apply it automatically. In the second one, it will be a mechanical process. So that is the difference. And I always follow the first method. So that, but you have to find which is good for you. Both methods are good, and don't stick to what I say. So, but you have to identify it yourself. Then fast reading is, if you use a pen or use your hand, you can improve the, identify the keywords quickly. You can even read faster with focus, concentration. So that will be good. And again, three factors that students are likely to face difficulty, according to the writer here, is one is vocabulary, that's the use of difficult words. And then some questions will appear twisted, and it is difficult to understand the question. So then again, another thing that is always there to put pressure on you is the time factor. How to overcome all these things? Vocabulary, I've already talked. And difficulty in understanding the meaning of questions, that can be solved only by practice. You have to read many questions, or you have to go through reading comprehension text and read the questions before reading the paragraphs. Understand what is the question like, what is the structure of a question, what are the different kinds of questions that can come up. So maybe they'll be asking the meaning of a paragraph, and they'll be giving multiple choice questions, which is again difficult to understand. So these things can be done only through practice. Even if an expert in English appears for this exam without practice, the person is likely to fail. Because the questions are, and the answers, multiple choice answers are given. If the multiple choice answers are given, it is also so complex that you will think that all the answers are right. So this is a rather difficult area, and without practice, don't think that you are very good and you have a good language power skills, you are a writer, you know what to do. But don't think like that. If you think like that, you are likely to lose. So go on improving, go on reading, and practice is very important, because as you see in point 6, most reading comprehensions are complex because it is taken from science essays, then very complicated fiction, and it is not easy to understand, and you will be puzzled by the questions and also by the multiple choice answers given. So on the whole, reading comprehension is not an easy task. And here the writer has given 6-3 solutions, as we already discussed. And the best thing is to do is to solve answers from passages that are not strictly from the English literature text, but also from science, arts, literature, politics, economics, newspaper cuttings, reports, all these. It will be helpful if you go on practicing. Now, the another problem that we understand is that most of us have this problem, is that we lose focus when we are reading. So to avoid that, you hold a pen and you try to focus and read without focus, because after 5 sentences, your memory is likely to wander. So that is a very important thing. And for this, you have to practice some concentration methods like yoga and maybe something like that. Meditation is good. So it's very easy to say, but difficult to meditate and do yoga. But still, try to, the easiest method is to hold a pen or a pencil and focus and read. Note, or maybe you will not be allowed to tick or add a mark because it is an examination, but still, you can you maybe put a dot somewhere. So that 1 point, yes, that is from one question, that I have read the question and now I remember that this point was there in the question. So maybe one, the answer will be from here. So just put a dot or something. But if you can solve the answer there itself, then it's okay. But sometimes the answer will be at the end. So you have to be careful. You have to read the whole thing. That's why when you go for competitive exams, you have to read all the by the whole passage. So that is important. Then there are some techniques, and here 1 or 2 points are said, but here the YouTube, it is good to go and see the speed improving techniques in YouTube, because everything is there in the YouTube. So you can improve your speed by, but don't listen to all the videos. Find out authentic websites and read and learn from there. Don't just think that whatever comes on YouTube is good. Now here again, 9, the point is, as we discussed earlier, of looking into looking up a dictionary is mentioned there. Don't look up the dictionary all the time, but just try to understand the meaning from the context. Solving previous papers is very important. As I said, practice, and then it will come. Then unnecessary things should not be bought into passages when you are reading. You think of maybe something. Don't avoid all those things. Stick to the information given in the passage. Then there is always something called panic, and you are likely to panic when you lose confidence and you feel that the time is almost over, so you get frightened. And always keep cool and never lose confidence, and learn what works best for you. Whatever strategies mentioned here, says the writer, they are not hard and fast rules. So what is to be done is that you have to find out what is best for you. This is just a kind of a discussion here. This is not a discussion. This is just a few points highlighted, but that doesn't mean that this is complete. So you have to find out your own path all the time. You have to understand that we can only just give some pointers, and it is for the students to go out, set out and find what is good for them. So, not just in this class, but in all classes, you have to just get the information from the teacher, but don't believe that what the teacher says is true. And don't just be satisfied with what the teacher is telling or the information that teacher gives, but always try to find out the truth. Or I don't mean that what the teacher is saying is false, but I mean that you have to find out what is more about a topic, what more can be there, what is some area which you want to explore more. Okay, so go ahead and do that. And if you do this properly, I'm quite sure that you will clear almost all the COMET exams. This is a very important paper, and it is very difficult also. So don't think that it is just easy. In mathematics, you have a formula to do that and to reach the answer. But here you won't have that. You have to really, really do improve yourself, and only the best candidates will be on, can reach the top. So always practice and prepare and be ready. Thank you.